go. This'll be the fastest froggy fly you've ever seen. I've made some adjustments to how I build this thing. First thing you do is put a good thread base. Tie on some deer hair. This bucktail. Nice big wad of it. Position of all this stuff doesn't really matter. I'm gonna put a couple of feathers on each side. Use the natural curve of the feathers so they point out. Basically like that. And gotta be perfect. Put them on the opposite side. Hopefully splayed out in the opposite direction. See here. See how they're sprayed out. That'll get some rubber legs. Get them spread out. I'll tie the thread down. Okay, the next step, what you didn't see is I took a piece of foam, craft foam, and I folded it over like that, and then I cut the general shape that I wanted. But I left it hinged in the back. What I'm going to do is run the hook through that, through the center part of that. Just like that. And I'm going to split that deer hair. See, so I got it on there like that. And I'm going to evenly split that deer hair. Bring that foam up in the middle of it. And I'm going to sandwich it together like this. Pull my legs forward. And I'm going to fill that thing full of super glue. And bring those two layers together like this. Share these two layers here. Super glue. Try to get these legs to stay forward. Top down on it, squeeze them together, pull those legs forward like that, squish those layers together, make sure your feathers are sprayed out real good, see how that's coming together. Now you just trim the excess foam to the shape you want. I trim the foam back so it's nice and even top to bottom. It has the general shape of a frog, top or bottom. These flies have a tendency to land hook up in the water. Sometimes they land like that, sometimes they land like that. If they land hook up, that's okay. That makes it weedless. It won't catch anything. Add color to it, which is what I usually do, so that no matter which way it lands, it has a profile and a color that I like. Looks like a frog. Color the sides solid. I'm gonna go ahead and put eyes on it just because I think it might make the fly look better to me, but it doesn't make any difference for the fish. Those eyes will probably get knocked right off it in short order. But that's a fly. That's a froggy fly. About as simple as it gets. It takes just a few minutes to tie one. You can tie a bunch of them because they're cheap. Craft foam, parts of an old spinnerbait skirt, whatever bucktail or deer hair you got, whatever feathers you got, color doesn't much matter. It's really the profile in the water. This is, think about what it looks like from underwater looking up on the surface. If it's got the right profile and they think it's a frog, they're gonna hit it. There you have it, the froggy fly.